Well, this is the kind of match every football fan looks forward to. A lot on the line and the likelihood of a tension-packed occasion. We'll have every kick of the ball for you live on EA TV. Good evening and welcome to Alcor. Welcome to the Al Bayt Stadium, the venue for this one. I'm Derek Ray, and adjacent to me in the commentary box is Stuart Robson. And both teams looking to get off to a flying start here on match day one for them at the 2022 FIFA World Cup. It's Costa Rica versus Germany.
Well, thanks, Derek. This is such an important game. Both sides will be desperate to start this group well. Let's hope we see some great football today.
And here's the starting 11 for Costa Rica.
Well, for a while, everybody played with a 4-4-2, and it can still be a very good system. But it does rely very much on your front two getting the better of their markers and the wide midfield players being good in 1v1 situations. Let's hope they play it well today.
Here's the starting lineup for Germany. Manuel Neuer stands between the posts. Niklas Süle starts with Antonio Rüdiger in central defence. Leroy Sané plays with Serge Gnabry on the flanks. And they line up with just the one striker looking to do a bit of damage. And now they get the ball rolling. Leon Goretzka, Kai Havertz, determined defending, and the upshot of that is offside.
Well, he needed to look elsewhere because the flag was always going to go up.
Superbly to take back possession. Well, the 2018 World Cup was a bit of a horror show from a German point of view. They didn't fare an awful lot better at the last European Championship, but many believe the time is now for this crop of players under Hansi Flick. How do you see it?
Well, I think they are an interesting side. I've seen them play well and look like world beaters. I've also seen them look a very ordinary team. Mind you, being a Bundesliga coverer, Derek, you should want them to win, shouldn't you?
Well, I'm always unbiased, but I do like to follow their fortunes. Let's just put it that way. Can he give them the lead? And Navas has somehow kept it out. And over it comes. Well, it still could be dangerous. A good and fair challenge. Celso Borges. Well, Kai Havertz, a gifted, naturally left-footed player who can dominate any game. Stuart, what do you expect to see from him today?
Well, Derek, he's a great all-round player, but it's his ability to run in behind defenders that makes him such a threat. And when he gets 1v1 against the goalkeeper, he usually scores.
Couldn't hang on to it. Contreras. Benete. Thomas Müller. Goretzka. Oh, lovely weighted ball. They might be in. Now the attack fizzled out. Contreras. Campbell on the ball. Oh, no stopping him. Splendid defending, and it needed to be. Serge Gnabry. What's he going to do here? Müller. It's a perfect challenge. Juison Bennett. Tejeda. Deserves credit for winning the ball back. Sané. Celso Borges. Contreras. And Borges with it. He'll be breathing a sigh of relief. Ball one. Leroy Sané. Joshua Kimmich. Serge Gnabry. Germany in a position of menace. But it fizzles out thanks to that piece of defending. Tejeda. Contreras. Still on level terms, moving the ball nicely. Well, he stopped them in their tracks. Serge Gnabry.
Well, as you can see from the stats, there's been little between the two teams. It's been really tight, really cagey. Let's just hope it opens up and one of these teams is willing to take a few risks.
Yes, a stalemate so far. Will it continue? Sané. And back with Goretzka. Müller. And that's fantastic goalkeeping to get across and deal with the danger. Let's see about the delivery. Well, a bit short with the clearance. Gnabry. That's excellent defending following the cross. Well, he read that brilliantly at the back. Anthony Contreras. Now with Havertz. Sané. Cross could be useful. No problems grabbing hold of that one. Disappointing pass. And he keeps going. But they took care of the situation defensively. Good strength to keep the ball. The referee has decided there will be just 1 minute of added time. Serge Gnabry. Oh, breezing past him. Gnabry! Well, there's a keeper on song.
Well, how did he stop that? That's just unbelievable.
And over comes the corner. Oh, fine stop. A chance then for the respective managers to address their charges. It is half-time here.
All in all, I think it's fair to say, an oddly subdued performance from Kai Havertz.
Well, it's not been a great performance from him today, but can he just find that spark? We know he's a good player, but not on today's performance. He just hasn't looked a threat.
Away they go again. Second half is underway here. Went in strongly, decisively. Leroy Sané. He has teammates around him. Gnabry. It might be the moment to get them ahead. Take it away. Can he find the net? Incredible save, and he snuffed out any sign of danger.
Well, those stats really do tell you everything. So many chances, but yet so little end product. At some point, though, you sense they're going to get the breakthrough.
Germany pushing forward with options available. Great vision from Leroy Sané. There is the goal to open the scoring. Who can say they don't deserve to be in front?
Well, here's the replay, and what a well-delivered cross this is. Perfectly placed, and it makes the striker's job so easy. All he has to do is make the right connection. It's a lovely goal.
So the match has restarted. 1-0 here. Brian Oviedo.
Yeltsin Tejeda.
And Borges with it.
We're getting the ball forward. Yeltsin Tejeda.
Danger here as he runs at them. Using his physical strength to make sure he doesn't lose the ball. Kai Havertz.
Leroy Sané.
Müller. Useful looking ball. And a goal it is. They lead by two now. Fully deserved.
Well, as you can see, he doesn't mess about here, does he? He's strong, well-balanced and skillful. That's a top-class finish.
So underway again, and a 2-0 advantage here.
Number 10, Serge Gnabry.
Well, the attacking options appear plentiful. Extremely sloppy in possession. Sané. This is Müller. Sané, and he's through here. Well, it was down to whether or not he could beat the keeper, and that question has been answered.
Well, I'm all for players striking through the back of the ball with power, but he has to hit the target from there.
Brian Oviedo. Campbell on the ball, and with that the attack fizzles out. Sané, good move in the making from Germany. Oh, managing to beat him. He read the situation defensively and did his job. Goretzka thwarted by the post, and problem solved for now.
Well, I have to say, I thought that looked to be going in. It was such a good effort.
Yes, a really open flow to the game. End-to-end stuff. A really top-notch piece of defending. Well read to ease the pressure. Now can they counter clinically? An effective challenge. And the emphasis is on creativity. But nothing comes of it. Good defending it was. This looks promising out wide. Müller, now Kimmich, and here is Thomas Müller. Well, I think you could call that an escape. It looked a certain goal, but he knew he had to get to the ball, and he did. 10 minutes left for play. Can they do something positive on the counter-attack? And a substitution in the offing.
Thomas Müller, coming on to the pitch. Number 21.
Joshua Kimmich. Well, he's given us away. And an astute piece of defending. Serge Gnabry and Kimmich. 5 minutes to go. Using all his defensive acumen to cut it out. Sané. And support available. Excellent vision. Well, I must say it did look so promising, but the flag is raised. Offside the verdict, Stuart.
Well, he's just too eager there. It's the right run, but he's made it too early.
Offside. Leon Goretzka. And that was a very fine read. We've had the official word. There will be a minimum of 2 added minutes. An alert piece of defending. And the final whistle. The big story here, Germany have prevailed. Stuart, your analysis.
Well, Derek, they were better than their opponents in all aspects of the game. They defended well enough, they dominated midfield, and they created chances as well. It was a great performance.
Well, a strong contribution from Serge Gnabry. What did you make of what he put into the match?
Well, he scored a good goal, and if I was his coach, I certainly wouldn't be worried by him missing a couple of chances. The fact is, he was a constant threat today.